Millions of Americans are afraid to go to work. A new study finds that nearly 30% of all adults report they've been bullied in the workplace.
It is a growing problem and an issue that has been flying under the radar for years now. But thanks to one California man, victims are finally speaking out.
It's a competitive world out there, especially in the American workplace, and some are trying to get ahead by deflating others. It's called workplace bullying.
We define it as repeated mistreatment by one or more people that takes the form of verbal abuse, conduct that's threatening, intimidating, humiliating, or work sabotage.
Gary Namie founded the Workplace Bullying Institute in the Bay Area back in 1997 after his wife reported being a victim. He says workplace bullying is not physical, it's mental, and it's meant to destroy your reputation, your productivity, and your work status. The goal is to make you look bad by any means necessary.
It is driven by the perpetrator's need to control somebody else. And so everything that the bully chooses to do, regardless of tactic, is about control, and it's all about their personal agenda and has nothing to do with the company's bottom line. In fact, it undermines it.
So who's doing the bullying? Studies show 72% of the time it's your boss, 18% comes from a coworker, 10% from an administrative assistant. But Namie says getting victims to report bullying at work remains the biggest challenge of all.
Key message for individuals is you're not alone and you didn't cause it to happen. So go ahead and partake in solutions because you have nothing to be ashamed of.
Now, Namie also says workplace bullying has led to suicide and post-traumatic stress disorder. Right now, no states in the country have workplace bullying laws in place, but 14 bills have been proposed in 10 states. California was the first. And if you think you have been a victim of workplace bullying, you should report it to your human resources manager as soon as possible.